You may think of flashcards as just being about rote memorization. Drill and kill, as they say, right? Flashcards aren't for real learning. They're just a boring, lonely, individual activity for regurgitating trivial facts and dates. Well, first of all, that's not true. It depends on what info you put on the flashcards. There's such a thing as good flashcards and bad flashcards, and there are certainly facts not even worth studying at all in a vacuum because they're too trivial. But more importantly, flashcards don't have to be used in a vacuum in the first place. In fact, we can use flashcards to transcend beyond just a behaviorist drill and practice activity into more of a constructivist, collaborative activity that will foster much deeper understanding of the material and provide much more convenient tools to help the knowledge actually stick in your students' brains. I'm Andrew with Brainscape, an adaptive flashcards app built on decades of proven cognitive science research into how we study and learn more effectively. We have built a tool that allows educators and students to crowdsource the flashcard creation from everyone in the class or from their peers in a way that leverages higher level thinking and keeps everyone accountable to one another. Here's how it works. First, you're going to want to create a class in Brainscape as your empty workspace for all the students who are soon going to be creating those actual flashcards. Once you're logged into your free Brainscape account in any web browser, just click Create Class, name your class, and boom, you're ready to start making those decks. I actually recommend creating all your decks up front too, even before you start adding any actual flashcards to those decks. Think of this as your outline, where each deck typically corresponds to a chapter in the textbook, or a specific lecture topic or video that the students have to watch and take notes on. Once you've got that shell of your flashcard sandbox all set up with all your decks in there and named, then you're ready to start inviting other students. Just click the old share button, choose your method of sharing, and watch students pop up on your learners panel as they join, where you can also manage their editing permissions however you want. Now this is where it gets good. Just start assigning Brainscape flashcard creation to one or more students per deck. Betty and John, you guys work together creating the chapter one flashcards. Jerome and Danielle, y'all do the cards for chapter two, etc. You can maybe even schedule each deck's flashcard creation throughout the semester so that the flashcards are always ready for all the other students to study just in time for each unit's exam. This process of student flashcard creation is so good for learning because it engages higher levels of Bloom's taxonomy thinking. Students are pushed to determine what concepts in the textbook or their lecture notes are flashcard worthy in the first place, and how that information should be best assessed in a question and answer format, which really helps the content to stick much better. And this higher level collaborative thinking doesn't just apply to the students who were assigned to make flashcards for that particular deck. Because in Brainscape, as students are studying each other's flashcards, they're not only getting the huge benefits of spaced repetition, but they're also able to suggest edits to those flashcards by clicking a little button and writing their suggestion, which will either fire off an email to the class admin, or will at least allow the student to make the edit right on the spot if they want, depending on what editing permissions that you set for them. By encouraging students to think, is this a good question and explanation? Or is this really enough for us to be able to study the material for exam? Will this be helpful to other students? You're getting students evaluating the content in a much deeper way while keeping everyone accountable to each other for creating good study materials. The best part of all this is that as you go through the semester, all the students in the class will end up with a cumulative set of flashcards that is ready to study for any cumulative exam that might be given along the way, including and especially the final exam. So as long as that flashcard creation is completed at least a week or so before each exam, people will have plenty of time to study, space their study over time, and ironically, they probably won't even have to study so much for the final exam anyway, because the magic of spaced repetition will have been keeping that knowledge fresh throughout the semester. Last thing, if you want to see just how fresh everyone is keeping up on that knowledge, then remember, you can always pop back over to the learners panel where you can, as the class administrator, track how everyone is studying and figure out exactly where their weak spots are. If you like the learning philosophies that we've discussed here, then please be sure to check out Brainscape and download our mobile app, which also comes with a marketplace of professionally made flashcards for thousands of subjects. Also, remember to subscribe to this channel for tons more advice on teaching, learning, habits, productivity, motivation, focus, and so much more. Because with all these tools behind you, then you and your class will be ready to rise to your challenge.